Hey, grown folks, Lady D, aka Donna Smith, on the weekend. We're talking about some grown folk topics of discussion. And I'd like to start this one off with, you know, that mate. You got that mate that, I mean, they're just your life. They're your world. They're your everything. They are just so freaking cool. They're your blessing. But it's one thing. They never, and I mean never, take the initiative sexually. Now, this could be a man that lays back and waits on his woman to approach him because he wants to feel that she desires him. Or this could be a woman who just lays back and it's like, here's all this. And if he want it, daddy better come get it. It could be that. But whichever way it is or whichever way their psyche is going, they never approach. So sooner or later, the other person becomes agitated because they don't know if they're truly being desired or not. I mean, once they make the approach and they start the sexual thing, that person is like, ugh, all into it. All they, you know, they blend and they mix and it's like, pow. But if they don't make the approach, the night goes by, the day goes by, they don't have sex. What's wrong with that picture? Would you say that could possibly be a couple that's just not connected anymore? Somebody's not turned on anymore? And if that's the case, why wouldn't the two get together and try to do more, you know, I would say interesting, enticing, intimate things together to help them get over that disconnection? Why just lay there? You know, I mean, there's so many relationships now and couples who are dealing with that. They are the initiator with everything. And in bedroom, they are too. They're the initiator with a new position. They're the initiator with when we gonna do it, how we gonna do it, how long it's gonna last, who's gonna go first. Who's getting on top? Who's on the bottom? Now, I mean, I know that some like to take control in the bedroom, and that's fine. And usually the man is the one, but you got women who kind of get sometimes, you know. But, you know, I think it would be refreshing if both at times kind of shared a little bit in that aggression of making the first move. Of letting that other person know that I am so turned on to you. Oh, I want you. Yeah, I want you. And I'm about to show you that. You know, I think we all want to feel that sometimes. Now, I could be wrong. And you guys may have some other, you know, feedback in regards to this. And I would love to hear it. You know, what do men really want in that regard? Do they want their women to jump at them and attack them and just, you know, just do the doggone thing? Or are women, are we just, you know, what we prefer or more comfortable with allowing our men to come to us? And when he comes to us and then we loosen up and then it's all on. I mean, does it really matter who comes to who, as long as you are getting down and doing your thing? And those are interesting questions. And I would love to know what you guys think, because, you know, it will help someone. It will definitely help someone who is feeling as though they are the problem or they are not pleasing their mate. I think this is one of the reasons why some people go out and cheat. Not to say that cheating is okay. I'm just saying some people will go out and cheat to feel that like, you know, letting them know that I still got it. Somebody desires me and wants me, and the person that I have at home could care less. And they go out and they do that. What's your thoughts? I want to know. This is an interesting, good one. And I want to know what you guys think about this. I really, really do. Because it's a lot of people going through it. A lot of disconnect. A lot of relationships going bad. And we need to help save them. We need to keep people together. Keep that love and that energy and that sticking power, staying power there. Let's help somebody today. Let me know what you think.